Hi guys, NixOS is gaining a lot of popularity lately due to its unique approach to package management and system configuration. In this video, we will introduce you to NixOS and then walk you through the process of installing it alongside Windows 11 on your computer. So before we jump in into the installation process, let's take a quick moment to talk about NixOS. So NixOS is a Linux distribution that stands out from the crowd due to its purely functional package management system. Instead of modifying packages directly, NixOS allows you to define the system configuration declaratively, which means you can easily reproduce your setup on different machine. Alright, we have basic understanding of NixOS. Let's move on to the installation process. Now, let's talk about the hardware we are working with here. I am currently running on Windows 11 on Lenovo laptop, powered by Intel Core i5 8th Gen processor. This is versatile setup and provide a solid foundation for our developer adventure. As you can see the processor and the Windows version. Now let's move to the next step. As we gear up for developer setup, let's first ensure that we have the required space on our system for NixOS. So here is my disk management. I have one SSD and one HDD. SSD is about 250 GB and SSD is about 500 GB, and I'm gonna install NixOS in my SSD, which is about 100 GB partition. Let me show you in my files. Here, as you can see, local disk C and D. C is 137 GB and another is 500 GB. So I'm gonna install NixOS here in 101 GB unallocated space. And now that's okay for this. It's time to move to the next step and download the Rufus. Rufus is used to create the bootable pendrive, and you need to download, of course, ISO image for NixOS. So head over to this NixOS website, and here we have two options: graphical and minimal ISO. In this case, we are using graphical ISO, and minimal ISO is mainly used for the server side. And we have two options available for the desktop environment. One is GNOME and another is Plasma. In this case, I'm gonna use GNOME, and I have already downloaded in my system. You can also download it. It's about 1 or 2 GB. Now this is my NixOS ISO file. I'm gonna create a bootable pendrive using this ISO file. So let me open Rufus, and now it's time to connect my pendrive. Here is my pendrive. Let me show you the pendrive. So here is my pen drive named as NixOS. This name is NixOS because I already created a bootable pen drive for NixOS. Now I'm gonna select ISO file. So in desktop, here is my ISO file. Click here and click on open, and don't do anything here, just click on start button and click on OK and click on yes. And guys, it will format your pen drive. Make sure to backup all the data in your pen drive. And now it may take 5 to 10 minutes. It's based on your computer speed. So let me fast forward the video to make the video short. Process is completed. Now our pen drive is become bootable. You can close the Rufus, and it's time to shut down the computer. So I'm gonna shut down my computer. My computer is now shut down. Let me restart it, and guys, keep pressing F12 to boot the system into the boot menu, because we need to fetch the boot menu. And here, as you can see, the EFI. Hit enter, and it will ask you some option about NixOS, like defined. It's defined as a bootloader, firmware setup, shutdown. Now I'm gonna hit enter on the top option, and it will boot our system into the NixOS. So let's wait until the system will boot into the NixOS. So guys, our system is now successfully boots up into the NixOS. First you need to connect your NixOS with internet, and first option is the location. You need to select your location and keyboard select as default and click on next, and here enter your credential and username. Let me enter it. And now it's asking for desktop environment. I'm gonna select GNOME. You can choose GNOME, Plasma, Mate, or any other from here. Now in this case I'm gonna select GNOME and click on next, and it shows that allow to download software from the third party. You can read this. I'm gonna click on allow and free software and click on next. Now this is the main thing, guys. You need to select your SSD first, or where you want to install your NixOS, and click on manual partitioning. Manual partitioning give the whole access how you want to install your system, and now click on next. And now guys, it's time to allocate some partition to install NixOS. First click on the free space, and we have click on the free space and click on click on create button. And here first I'm gonna create a boot partition which is about 512 MB. And here in the file system you need to select FAT32, and in the mount point select /boot, and you can give any label you want. I'm gonna give boot, and in the flag click on boot and click on OK. Now our boot partition is now created, which is about 0.5 GB, and it's time to allocate a partition for the swap memory. So I'm gonna allocate 8 GB to swap memory. And in the file system you need to select Linux swap, and in the flag select swap, and we don't need to choose any mount point here. Now we have two partition, one is for boot partition and another is for swap partition. Now it's time to create the root partition. So I'm gonna allocate all the left space, and in the file system select as ext4, and mount point should be slash, it's been root. And in the label, first I'm gonna give label root, and in the flag select root and click on OK. And we have three partition: FAT32, boot swap partition, and root partition. And now click on next. And it shows our information, like you choose your location, keyboard, partition, and you can double check here everything is right or not. If anything goes wrong, then you can go back and change accordingly. And now I'm gonna click on install. And guys, installation is started, and it may take 15 to 20 minutes or maybe less. It depends on your system. Now I'm gonna fast forward the video to make it short. Sorry guys, the part of the video got deleted accidentally. You will see such a screen in front of you when the installation is completed. So installation is now completed. It's time to restart the system to check NixOS is properly installed in your system or not. So I'm gonna power off my computer. So let me power it off. And let me boot the system again into the boot menu by pressing F12. So here, as you can see, the new boot partition, boot option, Linux boot manager. So I'm gonna hit enter. So here, as you can see, NixOS, and but there is no option to dual boot into Windows. So that means we need to install bootloader manually. For now, NixOS is not successfully installed on our system. So guys, my device is now boots up into the NixOS. Now it's time to install the bootloader. But before we dive in, remember this rule: backup your stuff before making any changes. Safety first, always. Now I'm gonna show you the configuration file of NixOS. So I'm gonna move into root and here cd dot dot. So guys, this is the configuration file of NixOS. This file is your gateway to tweak and changes. But before tweak anything, we need to make sure that we have already a backup of this file. So I'm gonna take a backup of these two file, configuration file and another hardware configuration file. So let me open it. And I'm gonna copy these two files and paste anywhere you want. I'm gonna paste in this drive. Now my file is now copied. Now we are ready to tweak and did some changes. First thing, we need to open this configuration file using nano, and we need to copy some command to install the bootloader. And here, as you can see, the bootloader option. And now you need to copy some command. Let me show you the commands. So here are the commands. You need to copy this line of code and let me paste here under the bootloader. And now press Ctrl S to save the changes. And guys, make sure to comment this system boot enable true and copy all these five commands. Save the file by Ctrl S. Our file is now copied, so let's check using cat. So yes, these commands are now copied. Now it's time to boot the system, so let me restart my computer again. So guys, as you can see in the boot menu, we have another boot entry, NixOS boot. If you open this, then we have three options: NixOS default, NixOS configuration, and Windows boot manager. Guys, if I press Windows boot manager, then my system will be boot into the Windows OS. So let me show you. So yes, my device is now boots up into the Windows by using NixOS bootloader. Let me restart again, and it's time I'm gonna boot the system into the NixOS. And now I'm gonna hit enter in the NixOS default. So guys, as you can see, my device is now successfully boots up into the NixOS. So guys, by this way you can dual boot your NixOS and Windows 11. And guys, this is the only way to dual boot, but we have another option, like we can install Defined and GRUB bootloader too. But this is the best way to install the bootloader into the NixOS. So guys, I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching Tech Jarvis.